My name is Cora, and I'm from Tenants and Neighbors. We are absolutely, there's so many emotions, there's so many feelings. We are excited. We just want to roll over and tumble over and jump. We've done so much. It's been so many years in coming. But we still have a ways to go. We're very, very excited. And right now, we're going to start out with our speakers. And first, we're going to have our first speaker. Let me focus my glasses here.
Senator
Michael Giannaris.
Yes. Thank you. It's great to be here with so many tenants from across New York. And it's great that the tenants of New York can be in a capital that they can now call their own for once. For years, the people that you see behind us that represent so many hundreds of thousands of others would come here and be fighting an uphill battle. And then last November, everything changed, and with a unified Democratic legislature, we are about to pass the strongest tenant protections in the history of New York State today. And you should all be proud of what you've done, but recognize that our work is not finished. Our work is not finished. If we got 90% of what we wanted, we still have the last 10% to go.
Right.
And so I have to speak and run, which is why I'm going first, because we have to start session and actually pass the bill.
Yeah.
So I want to thank you for letting me jump ahead of everyone, but I do got to say our leader's going to be coming, the speaker's coming, but Brian Kavanaugh and Zellner Myrie did excellent work in the Senate, yeah, leading the way to get us to this point. And this is our first session into the Senate Democratic majority. The Assembly's been at this a long time. Right. We're proud to be their allies in this fight. We're proud that they finally have allies to work with.
Yes.
But we hope we made you proud in our first session. This has been the most accomplished legislative session in history.
Yes.
This has been the most progressive legislative session in history.
Yes.
And we still... And we still have a week to go, so we're not even finished doing all the things we're going to do. And then next year, we'll do even more. So thank you for coming out here every single week.
Thank you.
Keep it up. Thank you.
Yes, awesome job.
And before I bring our next speaker up, which is Michael Giannaris, I want to say...
No, that was Michael
Giannaris. Where am I?
Okay,
Zelda. I would like to thank all of you, the legislative, and I would like to thank, it's because of the cooperation and of upstate and downstate that we became so powerful, and we could not have done it without each one of us and all of you in this together. So our next speaker is Senator Zellner Myrie.
I clearly cannot keep it together. Today, the tenants will win.
Thank God.
And we have been losing in this building for decades. But today, the tenants will win. It is because of all of you and many people we don't see, many people who are not here today, people who are homeless, because of the laws that are on the books right now, We think about you today. We hold you up today. For people who have been fighting for this since the 1920s, we think about you today. Thank you, thank you, thank you. The Tenants will win today.
Thank you so much. And we are all shedding tears inside. And it's just so, sometimes the words don't come, but we see it in you, and we're just so grateful. Our next speaker, Senator Brian Kavanaugh.
Yeah, Brian! Yeah, Brian!
Thank you very much. I'm also going to be brief. I'm getting text messages saying that senators need to get into that chamber and check in and get this thing started. But I do want to just add my words. First of all, my words of thanks to the leaders of both houses of the legislature who came together and said, we are not going to wait till the last minute. We are going to get the strongest possible rent and tenant protection laws done this session. I want to thank my Senate colleagues, Senator Gianaris, Senator Myrie, who you've heard from, our Assembly colleagues, several of whom have been fighting for this for so long. I see Linda Rosenthal and Walter Mosley and Harvey Epstein here today. And most of all, again, the advocates who made it clear that we were going to do this not just for the millions of people who benefit from the New York City and the surrounding suburbs rent regulation system, but tenants across this state who need the kinds of protections that we're passing today. First off, we are fundamentally strengthening the system of rent regulation in New York City that has been dismantled over many years by people who sought to end it.
That's right. That's right.
We have had a system that has been riddled with loopholes that have prevented it from serving its basic function, which is to make sure our communities are stable, make sure families can move into communities, put their kids in the school, and expect to continue to live there over the long term. We are preventing the kind of speculation that says you can buy buildings and benefit financially by removing the tenants from those buildings. We are ending a system where landlords can invest small amounts of money and reap massive profits through the MCI and the individual apartment systems. But more than that, we are beginning what is probably a long road to establish strong tenant protections for all tenants, regardless of whether they're rent-stabilized tenants. For every tenant who's ever been charged excessive fees and then not even been offered an apartment by a landlord, for every tenant who's tried to secure their rights in court and then been denied an apartment simply because their name is on some court record, for every tenant who has lived in an apartment and been pushed out without any notice at all at the end of their lease or because they have a month-to-month tenancy, for every tenant who goes into an eviction proceeding and is evicted almost instantly and has to see their possessions on the curb, their family out on the street almost instantly because our laws offer almost no protection for somebody in eviction proceedings in many parts of the state. For the nearly 200,000 people, the 200,000 units of in manufactured homes, many, many more people who have almost no protections, even though the places where they live are being purchased by speculators and they're being pushed out. We're offering the strongest possible protections in this bill. And again, all of this is possible. The Assembly and the Senate held a total of, I believe, 9 hearings across the state. We heard from dozens and dozens of tenants that the laws as they stand out now have not been working for New Yorkers. That is changing today. Thank you.
Thank you. People power. People power. People power. People power.
Our next speaker, Senator Liz Krueger.
This is probably the best day I've had in Albany in the entire 17 years I've been here. And I'll tell you why. I got drafted against my will to run for the state Senate. I came here in 2002. I did eviction prevention work and anti-hunger and anti-poverty work. And I got drafted to come up here and fix these laws.
Thank you.
Well, it took me a really long time. So when I got here, I immediately became the ranker for housing in the Senate. Well, it turned out nobody else wanted it because they said, well, we'll just lose because the Republicans control the Senate. So if you want to be a masochist and take on the housing committee, go ahead. I said, yes, that's what I'm doing. And I've stayed on the housing committee every year since. But it was only this year, when thanks to you and progressives all over the state, I was joined by 15 new Senate Democrats. Many of whom became the leaders in this fight. And we were able to push through the most important housing reform and tenant protection bills in my lifetime. And so I want to thank my new members, Zelnor, Senator Ramos, so many others who aren't here because we're supposed to be in chamber right now to vote for this bill, how much it means. And we only got here and we only got this done because of the housing advocates throughout the state of New York who helped us, who fought, who continue to remind us of the fundamental immorality of what we were doing in New York State to millions of people. So again, I'm so happy, I'm so proud, and at least now I know what I've been doing here for 17 years. Thank you, thank you.
Thank you, Liz.
To hear from one of our tenant advocates from Rochester, New York, and this is so powerful. We were going back and forth to upstate and meeting with the people there. It was such an amazing to realize that they had no laws of any kind. It was amazing. So now we're going to bring up Jesse Caranis.
We're
going to
bring up two leaders
right
here.
Andrea Stewart Cousin and Charles Hastings in the house.
So, I guess it's a great day. I just want to thank you. You all have been extremely patient. I know that when I first came, it was this movement that said, look, you know, we need some help. The Assembly, you know, needs some help. And I know when I got there in 2007, the first big housing was the vacancy decontrol. And I, you know, have been carrying that for years. to be in a position to work with my great colleague, my wonder twin, the speaker, to be able to change the lives for better in so many ways, for all New Yorkers, for tenants, for people who just needed to know that we weren't part of some scheme to make sure that you can't live in the city that you worked, that you educate, that made no sense. I have an incredible, and I always do this because I have such incredible members, and you know, some of them are here. I see Senator Ramos, Senator Zelda, Senator Zelnor Myrie, I see Senator Metzger, Liz Krueger was here, but anyway, and I see, like, I don't want to start getting into assembly because that will be the speakers, but the reality is that we came in 39 strong. Yes. And we came in, as you can see, strong enough to do the right things for all the people every single day. Today is another great day. I can't wait till we're not even doing it at midnight. We're starting early so that you can go home, so that you can go back and celebrate again. Thank you. Can't wait to get it done. So,
thank you.
So first, let me acknowledge the assembly members that I see that are here. We have Harvey Epstein, Catalina Cruz.
Carmen's
here. I see Carmen De La Rosa, Diana. An emotional Diana Richardson, Linda Rosenthal, Walter Mosley, and the Reverend Al Taylor. Miss anybody? But oh, and Brian Barnwell. You know, this has been a long road, and I have to tell you, it's a lot of emotional ups and downs and tough days that, you know, I got to be honest with you, I feel that people question the assembly's heart. And even though we've always been in the right place on the tenant side, and I think one of the things that got lost is, for me as the speaker, I crossed a line that no speaker had ever crossed in trying to invest and get in a Democratic Senate, particularly for this issue in terms of housing. I had negotiated one, you know, extension of rent regulations that we really didn't get much except an increase in the threshold. But we all knew that with the ability to have vacancy bonuses and the piling on of IEIs and the piling on of MCIs, raising the threshold was just a meaningless position in time, that it gave an incentive to have the landlords move to that number so that more and more apartments could be deregulated. But it is a great day for tenants. But I do want to say, and on behalf of the assembly members, and I do want people to remember, you know, in the dark ages when there was, you know, a Republican governor and a Republican Senate, the Democratic members of the assembly always stood strong. And I just hope that in the future, on the same issues, that all of you advocates give the assembly members the benefit of the doubt. We've never failed you, and we will never fail you. But it's a...
Thank you.
But it is a great day, and soon we're going to begin to vote on the bills that I think that will begin to, you know, reverse the tide of the last 25 years of the landlords having the advantage to having people not be priced out of their homes, pushed out of their homes, threatened out of their homes, forced out of their homes. So this is an absolutely wonderful day for the city of New York, the state of New York, because we've expanded this statewide. We heard the voices of the people in Rochester and Syracuse and even in places like Utica, who said that we need tenants to be protected and that we showed that we cared about tenants across the state and not just in New York City, when particularly when opponents always accuse Democrats of only caring about the city of New York. I think this package of bills showed that we care about tenants across the entire state. So it's a good day for all of the tenants, and congratulations to all of you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Let's go do the work.
Thank you.
This is such an emotional time, and I would like just like to say to the Senate and the Assembly is that there were times when we weren't sure which way you were going to go, and that's why you saw us up here in Albany day after day after day, sitting in, locking arms, being arrested. We wanted to make sure that you knew what we wanted from you and that we were going to stay and get it no matter what. But now that we see this emotional outpour, we know for sure that you were with us all the time. We just didn't know that. So thank you so very much. Our next speaker is a tenant advocate from Rochester, New York. It's been so important. And this is so important for us because we have gone to Rochester. They've come here, and we've formed this really big bond together that has strengthened us and to make this all possible.
Right. Good morning. My name is Kawana Smith. I'm a member of the Citywide Tenant Union of Rochester. And we're glad that people realize that there's a housing crisis all over the Senate. We'd like to thank the Senate and the Assembly for helping us. Okay. We're especially thankful for the rent stabilization. It would decrease evictions and increase affordability all over the state. We're ready to fight and bring rent stabilization to Rochester.
Amen.
Thank you. Our next speaker, Senator Julia Salazar.
This is truly a victorious day for tenants all over the state of New York. It is long overdue that we finally pass a rent bill that repeals the deregulatory policies that for so long have harmed rent-regulated tenants, have led to the profound loss of crucial rent-regulated apartments in New York City and beyond. And it's so critical that we are also taking steps today through this 74-page omnibus bill to also expand protections for tenants outside of New York City.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
It's long overdue that we provide relief to families so they no longer have to live in fear of eviction and displacement.
All right.
It is critical that today there is no sunset date in this bill.
Woo!
This is permanent because tenants deserve that security. It's wrong that we've had to come back here every few years just to fight for basic rights. Tenants are no longer going to have to play defense anymore. We are on the offense. We are making sure that this doesn't end today, but today is a historic day for tenants, and I am so grateful to be in this movement with all of you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Assembly Member Diana Richardson.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
I want you guys to know that I'm crying tears of joy.
Yes.
I'm crying tears of joy because this was a long and hard fought battle. And I've been elected in the state legislature since 2015 when we were right at the cusp of renewing the rental laws. And I watched as profit and big money took over people. I watched that in the halls of these same chambers where the right thing wasn't done. And it's not just laws, because when we go back home as representatives, we are watching what is happening on the ground. And I serve a community that has been ravaged and displaced and pulled apart from the very laws that we stand to change today. I have watched so many residents of my district lose their homes and come to my office for assistance, and I could not do anything for them. But today, because we have a real Democratic New York State Senate.
That's right.
And today, because I have real colleagues in the New York State Assembly, we were able to work in coalition as legislators with the Upstate Downstate Housing Alliance, the Housing Justice for All movement, and over hundreds of tenants groups across the state of New York to reach this very moment. And it is one of these moments where we will remember it for the rest of our lifetime. So I just want to turn to all of you guys, because I'm not here for the press, never been. I want to look at you guys as tenants and just tell you thank you.
Much. It is just such a great feeling to be here in the midst of all of you, and we just can't thank you enough, and certainly you're going to be in office next year and however long you need to be here. So we'll be doing it next. I'm losing track. I'm just so emotional right now. Who's our next speaker?
Linda Rosenthal.
Linda Rosenthal is our next speaker.
Linda.
Hi, everyone. So I represent the Upper West Side and parts of Hell's Kitchen in Manhattan. And when I came here 13 years ago, I was a beleaguered tenant because my landlord had tried to evict me. And I said, we're not going to let that happen to more tenants. Now, it took longer than we wanted, exactly right?
Yes.
How many years have we occupied these staircases?
Too many.
Too many. How many press conferences have we held?
Too many.
How many town halls? How many phone calls? How many mailings? But you know what? All that persistence paid off?
Yes.
Because today we get to do the right thing for the tenants of the state.
Yes.
Listening to all of us shout and whoop and cheer, you'd think we were at a baseball or basketball game. We are, because we played many innings. We hit the ball out of the park many innings, but this is the ninth inning, and we are going to bring it home later today, and I am so happy.
Touchdown.
I don't think I've been this happy in years. So thank you all. And longtime advocates like my buddy Delcinia Glover, who helped protect control tenants for years, and we delivered it for them, to the rest of the Housing Justice Coalition, Legal Aid, all of you who've been in the middle, in the thick for years.
Yes.
We need to have a big party!
Yeah. many times, right?
Thank you. Our next speaker, Walter Mosley.
Walter. Good morning. My name is Walter Mosley. I represent the 57th Assembly District in Central Brooklyn. As many of you know, that district is probably ground zero to the housing and gentrification that's taking place not only in Kings County, but in all of New York City. But I know we're on government grounds, and I know we can't talk necessarily politics, but we understood that if we're going to change the laws, we had to change the dynamics. We had to get our people who did not have our best intentions for those we call tenants and renters. Yes. We had to make sure that all blue was the same blue.
Amen.
We had to make sure that we had to put in people like Zelnor Myrie. Yes. We had to make sure we had to put on people like Jessica Ramos.
Yes.
And so many others who now call the New York State Senate their home. But we also understood that we as Democrats in the Assembly had to work with our colleagues upstate.
Yes.
We had to make this a statewide initiative.
Right.
We had to make sure that as much as we want to concentrate on the city, we are only as strong as our weakest link.
That's right. That's right.
And we understood that dynamic.
That's right.
And with those who are seasoned elected officials to those who are new, relatively new elected officials who brought new energy to this conversation, to those who were before us, who stood the line, who made sure that at the very least, we didn't take too many steps far back. But we also understood that if this was going to be the year we're going to change it, it had to take the courage of those we call our advocates, those we call our neighbors, those we call our fellow tenants and renters. Not only in Brooklyn, or the Bronx, or Queens, or Manhattan, but in Rochester, in Albany, in Syracuse, in Utica, in Columbia County, in Sullivan County, understanding that if we were going to do this, we all had to take a giant first step together. Now, we also understand that those who are in the special interest wanted to put brick and mortar above families and working families and children and seniors. And we also understood that there were so many before us who are homeless, who had to leave our city and state because they could no longer afford it.
Amen.
So we don't want to forget them. We don't want to make this so trivial that there are people who made the ultimate sacrifice and no longer call themselves New Yorkers. But now we stand here today on the precipice of history, understanding that, as Senator Gennaro said, we got 90% of what we wanted. We want to get that 10%. We want to be great. We want to be greedy. We want to take it. But ultimately, it begins with today. Because today, people trump power. People trump profit. People trump special interests. So I just want to say thank you to all the advocates, to those who have been in the fight for many years, to those who have come along just recently. Your worth is valued in the weight of gold. We thank you for all that you have done. We thank you for making a change in not only New York City, but in New York State. God bless you all. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
This is better than the Emmys. Carmen De La Rosa, come on down.
Carmen.
So we're here to say thank you. Can we say thank you?
Thank you!
We need to...
Muchas gracias.
Muchas gracias.
Muchas gracias.
We need to thank the advocates who really took on this fight on their shoulders and on their backs for our tenants.
Yes.
We thank you today.
Thank
we thank you for your courage
and
for giving us courage.
Yes.
Thank you. You know, I represent Washington Heights, Inwood, Uptown Manhattan. And I like to say that I'm just a little girl from Washington Heights. But in reality, I am a rent-stabilized tenant. A rent-stabilized tenant that has always been a rent-stabilized tenant. Because my district has the most rent-stabilized housing in the state of New York. But the reality is that my district is also the epicenter of displacement in our state and in our city. We're the last remaining community in Manhattan, and we're prime for speculation. We're prime for displacement because of the tools that have existed and that were created right here in this chamber. And the reality is that as a young girl, my father went on a rent strike because they wouldn't fix our apartments. And that rent strike followed me when I became a renter. And I was blacklisted because my mother and I are both named Carmen De La Rosa. And I proudly, proudly carry her name. And I proudly carry her struggle and the struggle of the tenants of not only Northern Manhattan, but our entire state.
Thank you.
Because tenants' rights are our rights. Yes. Tenants in this state deserve dignity. And today, we are reaching the goal of why we were elected here, to bring justice to the people in our communities who have struggled to just remain. These laws are about justice for our communities. That is why we call it housing justice. It's about dignity for the tenants. When landlords call me and say, but these laws will make it so that our buildings will be dilapidated, I say, come to Inwood and see what you've been dilapidating for decades. Come to Inwood and see the conditions that you have subjected us to. Come to Inwood and see how you have torn apart the tenants of Northern Manhattan for decades. Well, today's about justice, and today's about delivering for those constituents that sent us up here, that visit our offices. We get in my office at least 50 people a day with eviction notices.
That ain't right.
That's not fair. That's not justice. And many of those eviction notices are not because the person should be evicted. It's because they're fishing to see who they can displace.
Yes.
Because they're counting on us to be ignorant and not know our rights. Well, guess what? Well, guess what? Northern Manhattan is present here today.
Come on.
Brooklyn is present here today. Queens is present here today. Lower Manhattan is here. The Upper West Side is here. Harlem is here. Brooklyn is here. And we're awake, and we're also elected to give voice to the people in our communities who have been struggling against the monster that is corporate interest. And we're here to say that we're gonna vote on these bills and that we're excited and happy that our leadership took this fight on.
Yes.
But make no mistake, this victory belongs to the tenants.
Yes.
It belongs to working class New Yorkers who put everything on the line to say that we will no longer stand for profits over people and that housing is a human right as well. So today, we're proud to deliver dignity. I'm going to speak in Spanish for my bilingual people. Estoy orgullosa de estar aquí. Nosotros representamos comunidades de personas trabajadoras. Pero recuérdense que esta pelea comenzó y terminó con las personas que ustedes ven aquí. Personas que mucho antes de yo nacer o ser electa, están peleando por justicia en el sector de la vivienda para las comunidades inmigrantes, las comunidades trabajadores y las comunidades de este estado. Y esta lucha no es una lucha solamente de la ciudad de Nueva York. Es una lucha completa porque todos los inquilinos a través de este estado merecen esta justicia. Hoy yo, como un producto muy orgulloso de Washington Heights, voy a votar en favor de la justicia para que se haga dignidad para nuestros inquilinos que en el Alto Manhattan, la comunidad que yo represento, han sido abusados, han sido acosados. ¿Por qué? Porque ellos dependen en que nosotros seamos ignorantes y no sabemos nuestras leyes. Pero estoy aquí para decirle que nosotros sabemos nuestros derechos y no tan solo sabemos nuestros derechos, estamos electos para cambiar las leyes que no nos benefician. Estamos aquí para traer justicia para nuestros inquilinos. Gracias.
Sí se puede.
We are awake and we do know our rights. And now we're going to hear from Catalina Cruz.
Se me fue la voz gritando por las licencias. Ahora que les toca escucharme un poquito. Mi nombre es Catalina Cruz y represento a Jackson Heights, Corona y algunas partes de Woodside. Por muchos años me tocó ir a las cortes de vivienda a defender a inquilinos con leyes que no estaban a nuestro favor, con leyes que habían sido creadas por personas que tenían la influencia del dinero corporativo. Por años me tocó entrar a la corte y tener que decirle a alguien, no hay nada que yo pueda hacer por usted. Desafortunadamente va a perder su hogar. Me tocó llorar, me tocó sufrir y me tocó darle la mano a muchas personas porque era lo único que podíamos hacer. Una de las razones por las que me postulé era porque ya no quería que el dinero siguiera influenciando la vida de nuestra comunidad. Porque no era justo, que cuando yo tenía 9 años nos quisieran sacar porque no nos querían dar calefacción. Y al igual que Carmen, mi mamá dijo, no me dan calefacción, no pago la renta. Pero como no teníamos papeles y no conocíamos de las leyes, nos desalojaron. Pero años después estoy a mano de ustedes acá, porque esta victoria es de ustedes. Lo único que nosotros hicimos fue darle el empujoncito. Ustedes fueron los que vinieron, pusieron su vida en peligro porque se hicieron arrestar. Pusieron su trabajo porque venían aquí sabiendo que tenían cosas que hacer. Pusieron su comunidad en riesgo porque muchas veces vinieron caseros, como pasó en Jackson Heights, que querían comprar propiedades para hacer el target, para hacer otras cosas que no eran hogares para nuestra comunidad. La vivienda es un derecho humano. La vivienda es un derecho humano. Pero por muchos años, en Albany, la vivienda se ha tratado como un negocio para los ricos. No somos un negocio. Nuestra vida tiene valor. Nuestra vida se merece dignidad. Y gracias a mis colegas en la asamblea, en especialmente a mi colega Diana, porque ella ni dormía, la pobre, por estar luchando por ustedes. No se olviden el nombre de ella, ella ha luchado por ustedes. Y mis otros colegas que día a día nos reuníamos, hacíamos planes, hacíamos artículos, porque necesitábamos que la voz del pueblo se escuchara. Este paquete de leyes no es perfecto y todos los entendemos, pero es lo mejor que hemos podido hacer. Es histórico este momento y se les da gracias a ustedes por ayudarnos. I want to thank all my colleagues. I wanted to mainly talk in Spanish for my people in the back. I want to just thank all my colleagues because you guys have given me the chance to do what I want, what I set out to do when I ran. When I was a little girl, we were evicted because we didn't want to pay rent, because we didn't have any heat, because we didn't have any papers, because we didn't know the law. And then 20 years later, I had to step into a courtroom and tell tenants, there is absolutely nothing I can do for you because the law is not on our side, because the law was written by people who could influence the legislators with their money. Well, that stops today. That stops today. Because of my colleagues, because of colleagues like Carmen, because of colleagues like Harvey, because of colleagues like Linda, because of all the folks in the Assembly and the new folks in the Senate, we get to say, tenants over money. Thank you.
Next, we're going to hear from Senator Harvey Epstein.
When we fight,
we win.
When we fight,
we win.
I don't hear you. When we fight,
we win.
Today, we won. And we only won because elections matter.
Yes, that's right.
People who you elect matter.
Yes.
Organizing matters. Yes. People power matters. Yes. And all that together got us to this moment. So remember that. Remember the next time we go out and say, let's go fight. Get involved. Get organized. Get elected good people to make a difference for the state of New York. Because today's like today don't happen all the time. Let's honor the moment and tomorrow celebrate and then get back and fight. Thank you all.
Assemblyman Al Taylor.
It's okay.
Good afternoon, everyone. Let me say this.
Calle de la boca, por favor.
Oh, no.
Valencia,
por favor. Listen, I've only been here 2 sessions, but I served over 20 years working in a legislator's office, and I watched as our community changed. I represent Harlem, Washington Heights, yes. And I watched building after building, tenant after tenant, coming into the office, not having enough resources to fight legally, but even when you come out of fight, we found that preferential rent had taken over.
Yes.
And it made it difficult. And time again, you have to shake your head and say to the person, I can't help you.
Come on, man.
You live here, but I can't help you. I know what's happening, but I can't help
Come
you.
Come on.
But you all got tired of being sick and tired of being sick and tired, and you continue to fight. Because of your fight, you look beyond your problems and you identify some people with a voice that would register with like-mindedness, and you elected them. Not only did you elect them, but like a mother around their child, you watched over them and you made sure they did what they needed to do.
Yes.
Let me say this. Everybody did not come here because we wanted the kumbaya. They came to agreement because you kept the pressure on them. And let me say this. Do not pump your brakes. Do not pump your brakes. Continue to push, because the landlords are going to try to figure out how to push back. And we got to be ready to fight back. Are y'all ready?
Yeah.
We're going to fight back.
Assemblywoman Pamela Hunter. I want to thank all of you for coming today. I represented Syracuse, and I was the sponsor in the assembly for the Good Cause Eviction Bill.
Thank you.
I didn't know this would have been one of the most controversial pieces of legislation this entire session, and we got there.
Yes.
We got there.
Thank you.
But I have to tell you, we have a lot more work to do.
That's right.
I'm happy that we have put in for tenant protections because people call my office and they tell me about the squalor they live in and they are fearful to call code enforcement for fear of eviction. And where I live, you have 3 days to get out of your apartment when
right.
you are served
that
a notice.
Right.
That ain't right.
3 days.
That ain't right.
But we changed that.
Thank you.
We changed that.
But I just want you to know from the bottom of my heart, this has been a huge, huge struggle. You have no idea the courage that each of you have brought here in order to help lift this, because without your voice, seriously, we would not be standing here today without this huge package of legislation. We would not be here had you not been advocating. You're not yelling, you're not screaming, you are advocating for your civil, environmental justice, your rights. Thank you. And I just want the people who represented upstate to know, I see you, I hear you, and we will continue to fight to make sure that everyone outside of New York City gets the protections that they deserve as tenants.